A proposal to have a horse-drawn carriage in downtown Naples is already facing backlash. Just days after the city council approved the plan, more than 2,000 people have signed an online petition against it. But as NBC2's Sophie Nielsen-Colding shows us, the woman in charge of the tour says the petition is misleading.
I think it's inhumane for these horses to be dragging these carriages.
Soon after city council approved the measure, Collier County resident Camille Loge took to the website change.org and drew up a petition to ban the horse-drawn carriage rides. It has more than 2,000 signatures.
People don't want it. People are against it.
I love them like I love my grandchildren.
Danette Lavish is the horse's owner and the woman behind the business idea. She says Loge's petition doesn't paint an accurate picture. It reads, "The life these horses lead are hard. They work 7 days a week, no matter what." Lavish was approved to operate daily between 2 and 10, but told city council it would end up being less.
That's 3 days a week, 15 hours a week. That's less than I work.
What does it matter if it's 7 days a week or not? It's not right. Okay, it's inhumane. Horses were not born to be on the streets.
Lavish says her horse was raised pulling carriages and working the fields in an Amish community in Ohio. She claims 15 hours a week is more like exercise.
These animals are stronger than we realize.
Loge's petition claims carriage horses are killed and used for meat when they can no longer work.
One will be retired when he's old and live a healthy life.
Did you read her proposal?
No, I did not.
But Loge says she's against the idea of it anyway.
So let her make money off this exploiting animals.
If I break even with this, I'll be thrilled.
Lavish plans to start operating next month. In Naples, Sophie Nielsen-Colding, NBC2.
The carriage tours will run between October and May. If you've driven in Naples around the holidays, you know it can be pretty congested. Some adding horses to the mix will be dangerous, but the Naples police chief told us he's not worried about it.